break your heart.
Some of them come out.
So I hope that they've been taking good care of you while you've been here, feeding you those lovely, healthy Israeli breakfasts every morning, right? Lots of fish and hummus and eggplant and olives and all that good stuff. It's a very healthy way to start your day. I know many of our groups that come from the West, they prefer what many of our hotels have now learned to set out in the way of chocolate pudding. She would always use this as a place to dive in. So basically, she would eat it here. Half the dollar's channel. Well, what you see here behind me is that ancient Jewish tomb I mentioned rediscovered here in 1867. It was the basic reason the Garden Church Association would tell us, as well as the foundation of early church baptistry over on that side. But it was interestingly evolved from me. It's a symbol. We found part of the wall of the tomb here. You can see why I was raising it. Of course, for the believer, there is an anchor. See, we're told about a rich man's tomb, a tomb that is hewn out of the rock, man-made. And it was sealed with a great stone rolled in place over the mouth of the tomb. But underneath that stone, we're told there was a very low doorway. If we remember, when the disciples came, they had to stoop down to look in. Stooping down, they entered. Well, this is without question the rich man's tomb. In a little while, you'll all have an opportunity, if you wish, to go into the tomb. Going through the doorway, you go first of all into this large weeping chamber, a place where the three professional mourners would come to make lamentation over the body of the deceased loved one. To the side is the actual burial chamber where you lay the bodies. This is the traditional way in which rich people would get buried. And this tomb is indeed 100% man-made, chiseled, carved by hand, out of solid rock. It needs a lot of work and a lot of money to hire the work done. As we said, this is, without question, a rich man's tomb, hewn from the rock as we also described. But what about the stone in the low doorway? You don't see the stone here. We've never found it, no idea where it may be. But we know it was here, based largely on this channel or trench you see running the entire length in front of the tomb. Standard feature we find in many tombs used to hold a stone in place as it rolls. As for the doorway, it has been heightened in history, making it easier for you to go in and out. But we're told originally it would have been about one half of the height that we see today. Very standard for tomb building. Very rarely do you find a stone in the doorway more than a meter.
Yeah, I'm not. Thank you.